My name is Molly Turpin. I first got into forensics because I just love science, really. I'm doing a master's project in forensic science that's a collaboration between ESR and the University of Auckland. The features that are used for interpreting bloodstain patterns are primarily done on the walls, so vertical surfaces, and essentially there's been questions as to whether these are applicable to the floors. And so when you get to a criminal investigation, they're finding that that staining on the floors is completely ignored sometimes, and that's a huge loss of evidence, of course. So I'm coming in to pretty much go, all right, what are the features that we're seeing? Do they match up with the initial ones that are already out there? And if not, is there anything that we can add to that to make them a bit more useful for forensic practitioners? The thing that always surprises me with my research is just how messy blood is. I would say straight off the bat, every time I thought I've cleaned up the last blood stain, there's always another one hiding. And also the fact that my research hasn't already been done. So there's no existing research yet, which was a shock from the get-go for me, because like even basic knowledge of fluid dynamics, what goes up must come down, right? So yeah, that was something that really shocked me. But it's really exciting that I get to be doing something that is untouched, and that does seem to be quite needed at the moment in the field. Forensic science is still a pretty new discipline, and it's like ever evolving. So anything that can help get more information and like increase information value is just really important. So especially if we've got that loss of evidence, it would be really great to be able to minimize what's being lost and yeah, get as much information as possible for the scene. At the moment, it's a lot of creating my own bloodstain patterns and analysing those with image processing and getting data from those ones. So it's no human blood involved, it's all pig's blood, and no pigs were harmed for the sole purpose of my research. We collect the blood just as normal abattoir procedures, so pigs getting butchered. Pig's blood matches really closely in the viscosity, the surface tension, and the density of human blood, so it's almost like the exact match. So yeah, we're lucky in that regard. I'm still in the very early stages of my data interpretation, so I'm not entirely sure what direction it's going. I am getting some good preliminary results that are showing that there is a need to update or modify the standard operating procedures. One of the main problems I've noticed anyway is replicating real world scenarios and like controlled lab settings, because of course, you know, you're not really going to be able to hit someone in the head with a bat and see what happens. So I think developing those protocols would be really good, and especially for like arterial projections and things like that, and just simulating, you know, flesh and natural blood shedding events a bit better.